Children, I welcome all of you in today's EVS session. In today's session, we are going to see a new chapter, lesson number 16, day and night. Lesson number 16, day and night. Now children, on the screen you can see two pictures. What difference do you see in these pictures? What are the causes or the differences are caused? So we live on the earth. The earth gets light from the sun. The earth's shape is like that of a very large ball. Therefore, light from the sun does not reach the entire earth at one time and the same time. Half the earth gets sunlight while the other half remains dark. We say that it is a day in the half that gets light, while in the other half where sunlight does not reach, it is night. Every day we see day chasing night and then night chasing day. Night comes after day and then day follows night. This cycle thus goes on without stopping. What should be the reason behind this? Just as a top spins about itself, the earth too turns around itself. So the part of the earth that is getting sunlight goes into darkness and the part that is in darkness comes into the light. That is, where there is day, it becomes night after some time, and where there is night, it becomes day. Children, do you know? The sun rises in the east in the morning and moves towards the west. In the evening, the sun sets in the west. So, we feel that the sun goes around the earth, but that is only an impression. Actually, the earth turns around itself. That is why we have day and night on the earth. The spinning of the earth around itself is called rotation of the earth. The whole day has 24 hours, but are there always 12 hours of daylight and 12 hours of darkness? If that were true, we would have sunrise every morning at 6 o'clock and sunset every evening at 6 o'clock too. So, the phenomenon of a 12-hour long day and 12-hour long night can be observed on 21st March and 22nd September. On March 21, day and night are both 12 hours long. There is one part of the earth, daytime increases slowly and the nighttime decreases. This goes on till June 21. On June 21, our day is the longest and the night is the shortest. From 21st June, in our part of the earth, daytime becomes shorter and shorter and nights become longer. This goes on till September 22. On September 22, our day is of 12 hours and the night too is of 12 hours. After that, the day continues to become shorter. The nights become longer. This goes on till December 22. On December 22, the day grows longer and the night shorter. This goes on till March 21. From 21 March, this cycle repeats itself. Note that these dates may vary a little. So children, in this chapter, we have seen as the light of the sun does not reach the whole earth at the same time, there is a daylight on half the earth while there is darkness on the other half. The earth spins around itself. So the part that faces the sun goes into darkness and the part that is in the dark comes into the light. That is why we have day and night on the earth alternately. We can observe that the 24 hours of the day are divided into a 12-hour day and 12-hour night on 21st March and 22nd September. From December to June, the day gets longer, while from June to December, the day gets shorter. Now children, you have to read this chapter 3 times. Underline the difficult words, write them in your notebook, and then complete your workbook in neat and clean handwriting. Thank you. Bye.